بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمد عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وبعد، in the second hadith from the 40 hadith of Imam al-Nawawi رحمه الله رحمة واسعة، which was the hadith of Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu wa arda, when he mentioned that they were sitting together with the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that a yawm in a day. And he mentioned, إِذْ طَلَعَ عَلَيْنَا رَجُلٌ, and when suddenly a person appeared to us, شَدِيدُ بَيَاضِ الثِّيَاب, that his clothing was extremely white, and sawadi shi'ar, and his hair was extremely dark. La yura alayhi atharu safar, and there was no signs of traveling. Wala ya'rifuhu minna ahad, and there was no one among us that knew him. So that's really a sign of strangeness, that a person coming in the middle of the desert and nobody knows him in town, and he came with extreme white garment, and nobody knows him. So that means that he was not from the place, and he was neither a traveler. So that it was something that was amazing. That he came, he proceeded, حَتَّى جَلَسَ إِلَى النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ, and he walked and he proceeded until he sat in front of the Messenger صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. فَاسْنَدَ رُكُبَتَيْهِ إِلَى رُكُبَتَيْهِ, and he placed his knees right in front of the knees of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَوَضَعَ كَفَّيْهِ عَلَىٰ خَفِذَيْهِ, and he placed his own two hands on his thighs. He placed his own two hands on his thighs. And this, Sheikh Salih al-Fawzan hafidhahullah mentioned by way of this, the etiquettes of a talibul ilm, the adab of the talibul ilm. Meaning a person seeking knowledge, there is some type of discipline that is a must to be observed by a person seeking knowledge. And alhamdulillah, from those aspects of seeking knowledge is one has to have the proper sitting in the circles of knowledge. And likewise, Ash-Shaykh Uthaymeen rahimahullah even pointed out one day to one of his students about not playing with his beard. He say, so-and-so, لا تلعب بلحيتك, do not play with your lihya, with your beard. And likewise, as our nowadays issue is the telephone. Nowadays issue is the telephone. That a person will get up in the middle of the seek a circles of knowledge, alhamdulillah, to answer a phone call. So this is from su'ul adab. It's from the su'ul adab. From those manners that are very lowly, alhamdulillah, unfortunately. So he mentioned that Jibril alayhi salatu wasalam, he came until he sat in front of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and he placed his knees on the knees of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and he placed his own hands on his own thighs. Waqala, and he now start questioning. Waqala, ya Muhammad, akhbirni anil Islam. He say, oh Muhammad, inform me of al-Islam. فَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ, the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, الإسلام أن تشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدا رسول الله وتقيم الصلاة وتؤتي الزكاة وتصوم رمضان وتحج البيت إن استطعت إليه سبيلا. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in reply to the question of Jibreel, he said, al-Islam is that you bear witness, and we have covered what is the meaning of ashhadu. What is the meaning of the word ashhadu? Ashhadu. Ashhadu, the word ashhadu. What is the meaning of the word ashhadu? Anybody remember, remind us? ما معنى ashhadu? Sambala? Ahsanta, a'tarif wa uqinu, that I acknowledge with surety, with certainty. طيب, that I acknowledge with having surety in it, with having yaqeen of what I am affirming. He say, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, that he bear witness, that I bear witness that there is none worthy of worship in truth but Allah. طيب, and we have also covered the shurut and the pillars of la ilaha illallah. Kam shurut? Sab'a. Eight. Thamaniya. طيب, some say seven, some say eight, but it goes back, the seven goes back to the eight, and the eight goes back to the seven. Ala kullin. Because from al-ikhlas, the ulama, some others mention about, يعني that the individual, he al-kufru bima, bitaghut, bima yu'bad min dunillah, طيب, to disbelieve in that which is being worshipped besides Allah. And this is al-ikhlas. This is al-ikhlas, barakallahu fiqh. Wa anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, and I bear witness that Muhammad is the servant of Allah. He is the servant of Allah. And we mentioned about the meaning, the four meaning of Muhammad al-Rasulullah. We have mentioned about the four meaning of Muhammad al-Rasulullah. So inshallah, as Monday, we're going to be starting over the to revise the meaning of Muhammad al-Rasulullah. And likewise, the condition of Muhammad al-Rasulullah. What are, as we had covered, the meaning of La ilaha illallah on Mondays and Thursdays. And also, as we had covered also the condition of La ilaha illallah. So inshallah, next week tomorrow, we're going to start with the meaning of Muhammad al-Rasulullah and the conditions of Muhammad al-Rasulullah until we'll memorize it, bi'idhnillah. Tomorrow will be the 12th of the month of Dhul Qa'dah. The 12th of the month of Dhul Qa'dah. So you have maybe like 18 to 17 days before the end of the month, and you have 10 days or 9 days before the Eid after that. So he mentioned that Islam is that you bear witness that there is none worthy of worship but Allah, and Muhammad is his servant, is his messenger. That you perform the salawat. You perform the salawat, meaning you establish the salawat. Wa tu'tiya zakat, and you pay the zakat. And you fast the month of Ramadan. And you perform the hajj to the ancient house once upon a lifetime. Meaning if you have the ability to do so. So Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam, he say, sadaqta, that you have spoken the truth. Meaning that Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has spoken the truth. So the ulama, they mentioned that here they are the five pillars of al-Islam. These five things that the mentioned are the five pillars of al-Islam. And these five pillars of al-Islam, after the shahadatayn and the salah, if one is not carrying the other, then we will not say that he is a kafir. He will not say he is a kafir. طيب. Unlike the other pillars that are to come. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, after saying this, Umar radiallahu anhu, he say, we were amazed that he asked him, and he is testifying to him that what he said was the truth. Qala, Jibreel said, فَأَخْبِرْنِي عَنِ الْإِيمَانِ. Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam said, then now inform me of al-Iman, what is faith? And we had covered, barakallahu fikum, al-Iman, inda ahl-sunnah wal-jama'ah, al-Iman, inda al-murji'ah, al-Iman, inda al-mu'tazila. We had covered this, barakallahu fikum, al-Iman, inda al-khawarij. We had covered these things, barakallahu fikum. So he mentioned, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, al-Iman, faith is that you have faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You believe in Allah. You believe in Allah. Why is that the statement of you believe in Allah is first? Sulaiman. Why is that the believe in Allah is first? He mentioned the belief in Allah first. Why is that? Ismail, لماذا ذكر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الإيمان بالله أولا؟ أول شيء بمعنى الأصل، بمعنى الأصل، أحسنت، بمعنى الأصل. كما ذكرنا في الخطبة الجمعة، الإيمان بالله is the أصل, is the foundation. And الإيمان بالملائكة، لماذا الإيمان بالملائكة؟ Why was الإيمان بالملائكة after الإيمان بالله؟ Adam, why is الإيمان بالملائكة after الإيمان بالله؟ أبو زرعة، Go ahead, Adam. Why is الإيمان بالملائكة mentioned after الإيمان بالله؟ Right, but before that, very good, because they are the middle one between Allah and His creation and the human being. Because the malaika, they are between Allah and His creation. Between Allah and His creation. And then he mentioned al-iman bil kutub, or iman bi kutubihi, and believing in the books. Why? Because of the books, they are the. It is the revelation. So the revelation is brought barakallahu fikum from Allah by the malaika. So they are in the in between us. The Shaykh Hafizahullah mentioned this, the word he used, that the malaika, they are in between Allah and his creation. And then he mentioned about wa rusulihi, and believing in the prophets and messengers alayhim salatu wassalam. So he say, واليوم الآخر, and believing in the last day. And likewise, believing in the قدر خيره وشره. القدر خيره وشره. ما الفرق بين القضاء والقدر؟ ما الفرق بين القضاء والقدر؟ What is the difference between these two words, القضاء والقدر? What is the difference between القضاء والقدر? We read about that, huh? ما الفرق بين القضاء والقدر؟ ما الفرق؟ What is the difference between القضاء والقدر؟ If a person has a notebook, right? If a person has a notebook or something to write with, right? What is better is you have like a visible divider for every class you're taking. So you will not, okay, just write, okay. For instance, you will not write Sunday, August 13, 40 hadiths, but rather you will have a divider. You will take the notebook, or you will have different notebooks. So you, because this is part of al-hifz, right? If you write, let's say, on a piece of paper, you will lose it. I can show you a mini PDF, what you call this? Loose note, papers that I collected after the class, right? So one, rather, alhamdulillah, will have a notebook like this. But you will have a divider where you know, okay, the Sunday morning class is 40 hadith, it goes in here. So when you go to the class, it will be easy for you to real quick and go and look what is being said, real quick, right? But Amma, if you write in everything in a book without, you know, it will be difficult to go back to it. And these are, alhamdulillah, from the techniques that it will be easy to, inshallah, to go back to our notes and the like. Tayyip, what would you say? Yes. الفرق بين القضاء والقدر.
The قضاء are those actions that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doing at that moment.
Very good. The قضاء is those actions that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the actions of who?
From the actions of the servant.
From the action of the servant?
These are the actions that Allah is decreeing at the moment for the servant.
No, that's one thing more remaining. There's one thing remaining in that. طيب القدر is the علم of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala written in the law.